All right, so the challenge is laid out in front of you. Can you complete it? We're about to find out. Solo challenge, Madden Ultimate Team time. Let's go. From Las Vegas. Taken at the goal line. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. First play, and Hurts looking to throw it. He's got the hook up here to Deshaun Jackson. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
Well, this defense certainly knows they're going to have their hands full trying to slow down this passing game. Here's an example on the very first play from scrimmage. I think we'll see some different looks, maybe some pressure from different places, but it didn't work there, and it's a quick first down.
Play action. Here's Hurts. Open man, that's Devontae Smith. And he will go out right near the 35-yard line. And they get 17 more on that one and another first down.
But I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time, and a first down. Hurts. Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game that has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still two more downs to connect and try and pick up another first down.
Second and 10. Off the play fake. Here's Hurts. Flush to his right. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third.
Well, what looked like a march to the end zone is hit a momentary roadblock with that incompletion. No need to panic. They just got to come up with a high percentage play call and see if they can get their offense back on track.
Here's Hurts to throw. It's caught by Jackson. And they're going to get him down well short of the first as he can only get this to about the 19. And the 10-year vet knocks it through the goalpost. And the Eagles, they take a 3-0 lead. I think we can safely say they came out to be aggressive on the opening series, Charles. They didn't run the ball once. All that passing, it does get them the 3-0 lead.
I think what we saw there, partner, was a true definition of football balance, which means doing what you want to, when you want to on offense. And in this case, it was throwing the football. They may mix in running the football a little bit more as this game goes on. But this opening drive, while it stalled out, it still gave them 3 points.
They'll throw on first down to Graham. Oh, the first play of the game going to be intercepted. Jack Campbell with a pick. take possession 2 yards away from midfield at the 48-yard line.
Well, he had to fit that into a pretty tight window over the middle. And, Charles, I think they were in zone defensively, weren't they?
They certainly were. Nice read on your part. And sometimes the quarterback isn't fooled between zone and man. Sometimes just fooled by the type of zone that he sees. Because oftentimes those linebackers will vacate and run downfield with receivers. In this case, he played a pure zone and was in the wrong spot for the QB.
So now they have to contend with 2nd and 13 after the first down run goes backwards.
Hurts throw there, taken in by Smith.
And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to 3rd down. A couple extra tight ends in the formation here as they line up 3rd and 2. Here's Kamara trying to run for it. And I don't think Kamara got there. Looks like they stopped him short. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a 4th down.
You know, we might start getting some props here in the booth. You know, that one that says the D and then the fence that you put up next to it? How about that? They brought out the jumbo package and still couldn't move them off the line of scrimmage enough to pick up that 1st down.
Impressive. They were ready defensively for that jumbo sack.
So, Charles, they get to them with their 1st turnover of the game and then make it hurt a little bit extra with a field goal.
And anytime you give the ball up, what's the first thing a coach tells his defense? Don't let them score off of this. You've got to put out the fire. In fact, in 2021, that's what one NFL coach termed his defense. The firemen, go out there, guys, and don't let them put some points on the board.
The Charger drive about to get going. They find themselves down here after an interception on their opening drive led to a field goal. But all in all, you'd have to say fortunate to be only down 6.
Yeah, and you know how teams huddle.
All his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Eagles defense gets a pick 6 TD. Point after here coming up. And this is up, it's through, and extends their 1st quarter lead to 13-0. So they throw the pick 6, they'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. The Charger drive about to get going. And job one here, Charles, just keep possession of the football. 2 drives, 2 turnovers to this point.
You're exactly right, Doctor. Hippocratic oath. First, do no harm. And right now, they're harming themselves on offense.
I like that. No one is mistaking me for a doctor, though. But thank you, Dr. Davis. So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. And the Eagles are going to go ahead and take another timeout. And that's their 2nd charge timeout here in this 1st quarter. They're down to 1 remaining. First down, here's Graham. Open man is Kyle Pitts, his tight end. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. 13-0 is the score after 1. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. Now it's Graham. And that is caught at the 10-yard line. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. Touchdown from 6 yards away. And the Chargers have cut it back within a score. Extra point splits the uprights, and it's now 13-7. To
So here comes the kickoff, and what now is just a one-score, six-point game. Devontae Smith now from his end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. Last time out, you remember their drive stalled, but thanks to their kicker, booted a long field goal to at least get them three. Now here they'll try to do better and find the end zone.
And in our experience, how much fun is it for coaches to know that they've got a kicker who can nail it from long distance? Now, the hard part is, as an offensive play caller, you don't want that in your head too much where you're relying on it, and he goes out and gets the job done for them. But I'm quite sure he would be content to just kick extra points from here on out.
Yeah, absolutely, no question. I think his teammates would be okay with him just kicking the extra points as well. Second down, here's Hurts. Out of the backfield, that's complete to Kamara. And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down. And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going to want to be aware of him. Where is he lining up? What can he do? What kind of damage can he do to us downfield? And who can match up with him without weakening our overall defense? You're exactly right. It's a tough task to match up to him.
They only needed a few inches, but still some anxious moments there. But they do convert on fourth. And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. Got a man, it's Randy Moss. A big play there for Philly. 48 yards.
We know play callers can be very creative in this game today, but sometimes when they've got receivers with speed like this, they don't need to design incredibly complex calls. Sometimes it's just get the ball in his hands and let him do his thing. In a sense, less can become more, and it was right there.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. And here's Kamara on the read option, and he is going to lose yardage here. The Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
And that's exactly what you're looking for at the inside linebacker spot. Versatility. He can drop into coverage, or as he did on that last play, use his speed to get to the perimeter and knock the ball carrier for a loss.
So a 5-yard run the other way in the wrong direction, and that leads us to second and 15. They go play action with Hurts. They'll get this out to Kamara. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. This will be the eighth play of the drive. It's third and 7. Throwing is Hurts. And he's caught and stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. Chargers going to use their third and final timeout. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. They'll run it with Kamara. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the 5. A loss of 2 there, second down.
They have 3 tight ends in that formation. That's almost a universal sign that they're planning to run the football. But how about the defense there? They met force with force,
and caused a stack up behind the line of scrimmage and threw him for a loss.
Second down, here's Jalen Hurts. On the check down, he finds Kamara. Touchdown, Eagles! Alvin Kamara, a 5-yard touchdown. And the Eagles will extend their lead in the final minute of the half. Point after, right down the middle. And the lead now stands at 13. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Fair catch called for and taken down near the 5-yard line, and this will come out to the 25. The Charger drive about to get going. Well, not much time remains here in this first half. We'll see if they can get something out of this drive, at least a field goal. They can certainly use it, down by 2 scores. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. Jack Campbell with a pick. And the Eagles are going to have the short field here as they'll take over right at the 50. The Eagles in good position to start out as they come up first and 10 right at the 50-yard line. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. Here's second and 10. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. That's caught inside the 20. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. The Eagles will take their third and final timeout as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this first half. So after the big play, look at this, all the way down at the 15 now on first and 10. Hurts sets up to throw it. This one is incomplete.
No sense risking anything there on first down. Even though he's still in the pocket, he had a receiver out to his side, so just put that in a spot where the only people who could make a play on it are the trainers and the coaches. Well done.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Back to throw again. Steps away to his left. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them, and I think that discouraged him from taking.
Looking for his tight end read, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Joey Porter Jr. And he's giving his guys a shot for late points as they will take over in range for a field goal or maybe more.
And that felt like a little extra pressure on that third down attempt, and their mistake cost them points because they're inside the red zone. So you know you've got at least a field goal waiting for you. And in this case, they end up with nothing.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. He gets it complete to Jackson. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3 alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. The Chargers going to get the football first here in this second half, and they trail as we get back underway. And he'll be out of bounds here, a yard shy of the 25 of the 24. The Charger drive about to get going. Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well. They've kept them around in this game. Now they got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback.
It's caught inside the 25. Touchdown, Chargers. Devontae Smith, 76 yards. And the Chargers come right out of the locker room and score here in the opening minute of the third quarter. Extra point right down the middle. And the lead will shrink to 6. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This taken in at the goal line. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. Offense set to begin their next drive. And maybe some renewed pressure on this unit following the touchdown a moment ago. It's back to a one-score game.
And because of that pressure, because it's now a one-score game, they know this is where you need to slow the momentum change, because otherwise that could overrun your team. You've got to be careful right here.
Second and 7. Hurts dancing to his left, and he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. 6 yards there off the scramble, but it'll still leave him with a third down.
I did like his decision making there to make sure they picked up something instead of forcing a throw. Now they got a more manageable play coming up to try and pick up the first down, and don't rule out the possibility that he just keeps it and runs again.
On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. He's going to let this go deep for Jackson.
Oh, he had a man open. He overshot him. It's incomplete.
Oh, man. That is just a flat miss. He's in the pocket. The protection holds up. He sees his man come free. But maybe he just gets a little excited about the prospect of a long touchdown.
They'll try and throw for it with Hurts. Looking here for Smith downfield. And that is incomplete. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Chargers will get the football back in excellent field position. Throwing now, Graham on first down. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked by Ted Hendricks. And the Eagles are going to take possession here. It's a touchback. And they'll take over at the 20-yard line.
Offensively, when you see cover two, the thought has to go through the quarterback's head. Drive the football when making throws. It's not just the deep guys covering. It's the guys underneath you have to be careful of. Drive your throw. Otherwise, you see what results? Interceptions.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. Last time out, Charles, they opted to go for it on fourth down in their own territory. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. And the Chargers are going to get the football here as he gets this up to the 38-yard line. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 at their 38. They'll run with Walker to begin the drive. And they will only muster a yard here to the 38. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Now Graham looking to throw on second down. Throw out wide to Walker. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short. So it'll be third and less than a yard.
Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch. I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he is going to have the Chargers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
We've talked about it, CD, but it bears repeating. They are struggling to throw the football. All the interceptions and more incompletions. It just doesn't look like things are in sync out there.
I would agree with that, and it's not a good day when you feel like an incomplete pass is almost a win for you because it wasn't intercepted. And I think the receivers now, when they're running their routes, they want to catch the ball, but they also want to make sure that the defenders don't take it away.
On second down, Graham. And this one too low.
So this is what happens when you throw interceptions. That confident veneer that you have is chipped away a little bit. Maybe a little bit gun-shy throwing it around.
Yeah, underthrowing him there, and you're right. Those interceptions may be in the back of his mind. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. Graham going to look to throw again. Running back out of the backfield, and he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 22-yard line. The Chargers passing game rolling a bit here. They've got another first.
Well, they've certainly done a nice job spreading the ball around on this drive. This time he gets it out to his back, and it's another nice play and another first down. They've got the defense on their heels a little bit. They're reacting instead of being aggressive and making plays.
Now Graham on first down. Walker with a grab, left side. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the one. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first. And he takes it in for a Charger touchdown. Kenneth Walker taking it in from a yard out. And the Chargers have tied the ball game with a chance to go ahead now in the final seconds of the third quarter. The extra point splits the uprights, and that will put them on top here in the third. The kick unit on here for the Chargers as they will send this one away. This fielded right at the goal line. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further. The Eagles' offense set to begin their next drive. Their lead, they have seen it evaporate completely after such a good first half. They've been shut down here in the third quarter.
Searching for answers, trying to figure out what it's going to take to get back to where they were before. The big part of it is that sometimes you don't have to go exotic now. You go back to basics. Being able to run the football, string some things together, some effective passes, try and get a rhythm established again, and try and get back in the lead.
Line of scrimmage, the 28 now as they come up on second and a couple. From the gun, it's Hurts. Room past the 35, and he'll take it to the 43-yard line. Philadelphia picking up the first on a gain of 15.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, to watch him drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know, this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed, too.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
And a smart play there. He's probably saying, I wish I would have done that on the last drive instead of throwing the interception.
Now Hurts going to shift him around a bit to throw on second and 10. Hurts drops this off to Kamara out of the backfield. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
He's going to get that to his running back out of the backfield. And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers' 27-yard line. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
Now that some time outside of the pocket, waiting for someone to come open. And when he did, he put it on him for a big play and a first down.
So it looks like they still have some fight in them on this series, because it seemed like things were headed for the red zone. But if this defense gets two more stops, they can keep them out of that area.
They'll try again here, second and 10. Hurts. And this is caught. Touchdown, Philadelphia. DeSean Jackson, 27 yards. And the Eagles answer back with a touchdown of their own to take a fourth quarter lead. But plenty of scoring here of late, and our lead changes hands now in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, they just gave up a touchdown on the other end, so they knew that with time getting short, they had to put something together here, and they were able to do so and retake the lead right back.
Flushed out right. And he's got it. So the two-point conversion is good, and they add on to their fourth quarter lead. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Fair catch called for and taken back near the goal line. So that'll come out to the 25. This is first and 10. Here's Graham to throw it. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down.
It's easy to see when we review this that the ball needs to come out quicker, because if you don't throw it right on the break, you bring a crowd of people into the equation.
And that's why it got knocked away there. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds.
Like the design that we're seeing right there, this is what they need. Down by a touchdown here in the fourth, they just need to keep working their way downfield, and when they see openings, take their shots.
Airing it out deep for Smith. That's caught inside the 20. So it's Charger football as we welcome you back from the two-minute warning. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. On first and 10, it's Graham. Throw over the middle, going to be caught here by Pitts. And the Chargers are going to be set up with a first and goal coming up as they get him down at the 6-yard line. Now they'll audible to something else. Bringing it in, Jackson left side.
Sometimes it's hard to figure, but you can live with incompletions in this situation. You can't live with these short gains that take time off the clock.
You know who loves it? This defense. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Walker, and he will get in across the chalk for a Chargers touchdown. Ken Walker, his second touchdown of the night, and the Chargers are an extra point away from tying this game here in the final minutes. Don't forget the extra point, it's up and good, and we are tied here in the fourth quarter. This one setting up for a great finish. All tied in the fourth as the kick's away. And he'll be stopped up at the 25. and 10 here. Here's Hurts to throw. Jackson with a catch. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield.
And this is obviously a spot where you lean on your stars. Get the ball to them in open space and let them do what they do.
Two timeouts still available in this final minute. It's first and 10 now. Throwing is Hurts. It's complete, Kamara. And he is going to lose yardage here.
Partner, they're clearly saving those timeouts, but they still have to work with some urgency to put themselves in the right position.
Here comes second down. They'll set up to throw. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. How about the call to come with the blitz there in this situation?
And some of those calls happen just because of what they do on offense. And when they send out a number of people in the pattern, sometimes they'll just make a change on defense, say, okay, we'll come after you instead. And that's exactly what they did.
Flag comes in. This might be a free play. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on, a big call coming on third down. So they take the flag and the yardage that comes with it. They'll come to the line now on a third and 6. Again, he'll drop to throw. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Well, the defense certainly did its job. They held up in that situation, and now fourth down, you've got to punt this and try to get to overtime. There's no decision to be made, in my estimation.
Here we go. This is fourth down. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Jackson. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. Both sides were holding their breath there on that fourth down play, and the offense could breathe a sigh of relief.
And both knew exactly where the first down markers were. You know the defense is trying to guard those sticks and try and keep people in front, but somehow, some way, those guys found a way to pick it up.
Well, this offense still has the one timeout here, remember. First and 10. Trying the left side with Kamara, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up. Well, the Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the ball game. Second down, 8 yards to go. They run it again with Kamara. Look at this, middle of the field, a breakaway. Unable to corral him, he fights through. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. Get the timeout. A huge play has him in field goal range with a chance to win. And we will get a timeout with 2 ticks left. And now this game's going to come down to the right leg of their kicker. 2 seconds on the clock. This for the win. And his kick is good. He knocks through his third field goal of the game, and this one is the one that decides it. But now there is a penalty marker on the field, so let's see what this is about. Well, partner, you and I were excited for this one today and certainly had its moments. Some good execution at times by both of these offenses. Defenses both made some plays as well. And always a joy to be up here in the booth next to you, my friend.
Yeah, it's a privilege to be up here in the booth next to you as well. Thanks for taking the time. And let's go ahead and get ready for our next one, right? I'll see you in the film room. Get that preparation started now.